everyone. Welcome to day three this week in math learning. Today we are still focusing on location in geometry. And I want to remind you not to forget to do your computational fluency at the top of your notebook today. And so that means writing the date, writing your numbers from 1 to 10 with no reversals. Take your time on this. Even though I know you know how to do it, taking your time to print those numbers neatly is really important. And in a straight line, try to find a clock in your house and tell the time. Practice telling the time as much as you can. One addition, one subtraction sentence. And I've remembered what the last piece was that I kept forgetting to tell you about. And it was choosing two coins in money and adding them together. And if you want a challenge, you can try to add three coins together. You could try to add four coins together. And just, we don't want to lose that practice of adding those different money amounts together, okay? So once you've got that done, you can move on to your problem solving. And today in problem solving, our learning goal is I can draw a map. So today you get to draw your very own map and describe locations on it. So your very first job is to draw a map of one floor of your house. Now, some people only have one floor to begin with. Some people have two floors, some people have three floors, but it could get kind of complicated if you try to draw all three floors. So I want you to choose one floor of your house, and you're going to draw a map of it, and you're going to label it, and then you're going to tell me how to get from one spot in your house to another using that positional language that we learned about yesterday. Okay, so your first job will be, so what would your title be of your map? So my title is going to be My House Map. Okay? And the first thing I'm going to do is think about where the doors might be. And that seemed to help me yesterday think about where everything was in relation to each other. So when I think about a door that comes in, I have a door that comes in over here. So I'm going to just label that door. And then as you come in the door, I'm going to use a different color to separate the walls. So as you come in the door, you will see, and sometimes you have to actually go stand at the door and then look to your left. What do you see? And then look to your right. And what do you see? So when you come in the door, when you look to the right, there is a kind of doors here because this is the closet. So I'm just going to draw this here. Closet, and then over here, even though there's no walls, maybe what I'll do is when there's no walls, I'll draw a dotted line, and then you'll know where there's walls and where there's not. So all along here, as you walk in, so there's no wall here, but this is kind of the space for the kitchen, okay? So I'm going to label that kitchen. And then over here, there's no walls, but over here, it's pretty much the living room. Okay. And then there is a hallway. So I think, so there's no doors right there, but then there is a door if you keep on going past the living room. There's a door here. Oh, my doors are green. There's a door here. There's a door here. And there's a door here. Okay, and so what I'm actually going to do is draw all my walls with orange. Okay? Oh, no. I'm doing my walls in blue. So, this room connects here, and then this room connects about here, It's not going to be perfect, but this will be my sort of best work. Okay, so this is a bathroom. This is my room. And this is Paisley's bedroom. And what else do I want to do? Maybe I could label this as the hallway. Okay, so now I've got a fairly simple map that I've drawn of one floor. And now what I need to do is think about what I have to choose a color and put two X's on my map. And one of the X's is going to be the starting point of how I describe where to go into my house. Okay, so my next job is to describe a location. So if I were to describe how to get from my bedroom to the front door, that's a pretty simple explanation. So I'm going to model that one. So here's what where I want to explain to people. How to get from this front door to my room. And I'm going to draw exactly what you need to do. Walk a straight line ahead, pretty much, right? So I do need to put a title there, though. So how to get from the front door to my bedroom. Okay, so how do I get from my front door to my bedroom? So my instructions would be walk straight ahead and through my bedroom door. Now I'm going to actually underline the positional language that I used in my instructions. So some of the positional language that I used that actually wasn't on our list yesterday was straight, ahead, through. So those are all the words that I used to describe how to get somewhere, which described a location. Okay, so now your job is to do your computational fluency in your notebook, then draw your map of one of the floors of your home, and then tell me how to get from one spot to another spot in your house. Once you've written that down, I want you to underline all of the positional language words that were in your sentence, okay? Have fun, guys, and I can't wait to see your work.